Hey there. When we talk about Frank Zappa's music, a lot of things come to mind immediately. Most people would probably mention the rhythmic element first, then his wild melodies, and the combination of both of those together. And harmonically, we know he loves to use chords that usually don't have thirds in them. But what about his chord progressions? So normal chord progressions usually function diatonically, meaning they adhere to a scale and specific set of notes. In our diatonic music, like the major scale, which contains major, minor, and diminished triads, we're mostly looking at root movement, where we see stuff usually like 1 to 4 or 5, 2 to 5, 3 to 6, and so on. Basically where the strongest root motion is by fifth, and we have functional harmonic progressions. The opposite would be chromatic, which consists of all 12 notes, and appears in non-functional settings. But a lot of what we see in Zappa's chord progressions, diatonic or chromatic, is stepwise root motion. This means the root is moving in either half steps or whole steps. For example, here in Ain't Got No Heart.
Ain't got no heart. I ain't got no heart to give away. I'll sit and laugh at fools in love. There ain't no such thing as love. No angel singing up above today.
Flakes is another good example, both in the verse.
Don't do no good. They never be worth it when they are to shut. They waste your time. They waste their mind. California's got the most of them. Boy, they got a host of them. Swear to God, they got the most.
And the bridge.
When I ask as nice as I can. If my job would somehow be finished by Friday.
And of course, he loves moving by step when the harmony is working in non-functional ways as well. The Drowning Witch interlude immediately begins with these Lydian chords descending by half step. Revised music for guitar and low-budget symphony orchestra begins with the root movement ascending by steps. And Rollo sees the root movement descending by steps.
Here's the church and here's the steeple. See the people, some are kneeling, some are standing. All the money they are handing to some asshole with a basket. Where it goes, we dare not ask it.
So what exactly is Frank Zappa's favorite chord progression? Well, it has stepwise root movement just like we looked at, and involves a minor 7 ascending or descending to a major 7, or vice versa. We can call this the Black Napkins progression, as it's probably the most famous example, where we see C sharp minor 7 go up a step to D major 7. You can see that it's actually a lot like minor 1 to minor 4, in this case, C sharp minor to F sharp minor, as the top three notes of D major 7 spell out F sharp A C sharp. But now, with the root just moving up a step instead, and we have D in the bass on that F sharp minor. If we're looking to call C sharp our key and say this is diatonic, well, we could, as sort of a Phrygian tonality, and D major 7 acting as the flat 2. But I think labeling Black Napkins as Phrygian would be incorrect. And suggesting to use that scale to solo over this chord progression would be even worse advice, that Zappa himself would clearly disagree with, seeing as he almost always defaults to A sharps and D sharps over the C sharp minor 7. That means we're thinking two different scales for each chord, and Zappa is using this in a general chromatic sense, something I called modal center switching in my videos on Alien Orifice and Montana. In this case, and really all of the center switching examples I'll show, the minor 7 will see the Dorian mode, and the major 7 will see Lydian. Now of course that doesn't mean he won't use this progression diatonically. We'll see plenty of examples like that. He'll use these two chords in any direction and order, meaning we can see minor up or down to major, and major up or down to minor. So knowing that this chord progression can function chromatically or diatonically, and in any order, let's look at them all as a case-by-case basis, and see just how common Frank Zappa's favorite chord progression is, and how creative he gets with it. Let's start with minor up to major. So we already talked about Black Napkins, obviously, where we see C sharp minor 7 to D major 7, and each represents a new scale set, meaning it's a chromatic example. The wonderful thing about the melody of Black Napkins is how he uses the common tones between the two chords. C sharp E, F sharp, G sharp B, a C sharp minor pentatonic scale. I really love especially how he lands on that C sharp when it changes to the D major 7. It plays with your ear a bit, and it's the common note between the two changes. But what about a diatonic example? Well, how about I'm Not Satisfied, where we see the first two chords are the same ones as Black Napkins, only this time he adds an E major after. Another stepwise root movement example, of course, as so much of Zappa's writing is. This time I would categorize this as diatonic in E Mixolydian, working as 6, flat 7, and 1. Remember we talked about the major chord in this progression being a sub, in this case D major instead of F sharp minor, which would be the 2 in the key. And 6 going to 2 is very standard normally, just with this Mixolydian twist of the flat 7, D, in the bass, leading to this walk up back to 1. So we have one chromatic and one diatonic. Let's look at one more using C sharp minor and D, which is Andy.
Show me a sign, if you don't mind. Show me a sign, if you don't mind. Show me a sign, if you don't mind. Show me a sign, if you don't mind.
Now you may be questioning my thinking here because of that big old F sharp dominant chord that precedes the D chord, but just bear with me. In this funk section we see C sharp minor and F sharp 7, a classic minor 1 to major 4 progression that many a scholar would classify as a Dorian sound. It's so interchangeable really that I'm thinking of this section as just that one modal center. This means of course when we switch over to D and we see plenty of F sharps and G sharps indicating a Lydian sound, this makes this section really no different from Black Napkins in my mind. You wouldn't bat an eye if someone comping on Black Napkins threw in some A sharps on that C sharp minor 7, or if a soloist outlined that F sharp 7 harmony. So really we're still seeing this chord progression Zappa loves here, just a little more dressed up with that dominant 4 chord in between. Alright, we can't go much further without another classic example, which is Jumbo Go Away.
Jumbo Go Away, hey, hey, hey. Jumbo Go Away, hey, hey, hey. Jumbo Go Away, hey, hey, hey. Jumbo, leave me alone.
Here we have the Black Napkins progression down a whole step. Now B minor 7 to C major 7. So you can see in the three-part vocal harmony that we have 7 total notes, a scale, between both chords. G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp. That's clue number 1 that this is probably used diatonically. Clue number 2 is the chords that come after this progression, now A minor and D. Well, there's no real dominant function here. After the D, it goes back to B minor 7 instead of resolving by 5th root movement, which in this case would be G. But check it out. If we still assume these chords are all G major centered, it would make a lot of sense. B minor is the 3 chord in this instance, and 3 is frequently used as a substitute for 1. Now that root movement actually makes a lot of sense. It's basically a 1, G major, but with a B minor sub, to 4, C major, to 2, A minor, to 5, D. And instead of Zappa going through it like that, he keeps the classic stepwise root movement in there. So ultimately, Jumbo Go Away is a diatonic example. If you're interested in that crazy middle section, well, I made a video on that too. Now we're gonna go through a bunch of examples that use E minor to F. The first one here is 50-50 off Overnight Sensation. Let's take a listen. Remember how I showed earlier how Zappa loves to move in steps like Drowning Witch, Rollo, or Revised Music? This is another classic example. We see D minor 7, E flat minor 7, E minor 7, F major 7, And this is a great modal center switching example, going from D Dorian to E flat Dorian to E Dorian to F Lydian, just for the first four chords. Our Black Napkins progression is here, from E minor to F. And notice in the melody as it lands on E, the would-be root of the E minor 7 chord, he cleverly switches to F major 7. E is, of course, a common tone between the two harmonies. Remember how we talked about this in Black Napkins? Well, it's the same exact thing. Both melodies land on the root of the first minor chord, while the harmony switches to the major chord up a step. So ultimately, a very chromatic example here. Our next E minor to F example is from Mom and Dad. He clearly sets up an E Dorian tonality with the first instrumental melody, plenty of F sharps and C sharps. Then the first two bars are the Black Napkins progression again, E minor to F, taking us out of that sound due to the F naturals and C naturals. You can see that pretty much continues. We see C natural afterward, although we're back to F sharps until the last 2-4 bar, back to the intro melody. So this all makes sense as an E natural minor sound, right? E, F sharp, G, A, B, C natural, D, otherwise known as Aeolian, a rare sound for Zappa. But otherwise, how do we explain that F major 7? Well, here it's working as a borrowed chord, or a chord from the parallel key, in this instance, E Phrygian. This is also known as modal mixture, since we're mixing natural minor and Phrygian. It happens so briefly that we still consider it in the original tonality, not as a modulation. And ultimately, this is another diatonic example here. Don't forget also that the major chord is a sub, this time for A minor, and the E natural minor thing makes even more sense now. How about Sleeping in a Jar? I would say this is pretty D Mixolydian centered in the melody and the first two chords. And when he takes it down to B flat sus 2, I think he's just continuing the sequence of the chords descending down a step. Remember, he loves patterns like this, whether it's down by half step, whole step, thirds, whatever. But he hits the 2 chord here on E minor, and then a flat 3, F major 7. I would say this is another instance of borrowing, this time from D minor, but since this is all pretty much D major Mixolydian centered, I would say this is another diatonic example of the Black Napkins progression. Let's look at one of my all-time favorites, Punky's Whips. I'd love to make a video on the entire piece one day. But here's a great part. So right away you can see the time signature of 7/16. This ascending contour looks pretty stepwise. What do you know? We have a 7 note scale here in the first bar. Starting on B, we then have C sharp, D, E, F sharp, G, A, which would be B Aeolian in any other circumstance, but there's an E in the bass. Starting the scale on E means we have E Dorian. And the next bar continues that pattern until we get to the F sharp again, where it starts to descend back down. Next 3/3/16 bars still have E under the bass, where he has this repeating figure of an 8th and 16th. Now the 3/3/16 bars after that, I will admit, it takes us completely out of E and not up to a major. But for the sake of my argument here, let's treat this like a little slight interlude before we see where it really lands, on F here. This little lick is really just a parody of the first one, although you can see it's got a major 3rd, a sharp 4, and a major 7. Clearly indicating this is Lydian. So he presents you two versions of these scalar licks, the first in E Dorian, then in F Lydian. Ultimately chromatic, although we will see more of this piece later. Let's see another E minor to F in 20 small cigars. Here we have this E minor to E minor major 7. Before landing on F, and seeing a straight arpeggio starting on the root. Well, this could kind of seem diatonic if you're thinking E minor and the F being borrowed, but after examining some of the other root movement, we see patterns like steps or minor thirds. That's very Zappa-like, and ultimately this makes me think this is a chromatic tune, and we'll revisit it later. So there are a couple more E minor to F examples, like Village of the Sun or How Could I Be Such a Fool, but I think you get the point. Let's look at our last example that has minor up to major, but also has two more of minor down to major. Our old friend, Alien Orifice. So the minor up to major happens here, A to B flat. Ignore the enharmonic spelling. Let's just call this F sharp, C sharp, D sharp, G sharp. Very clearly Lydian with the sharp 4 before moving to B flat Dorian here with our natural 6s. Now this is a great transition because he goes the other way, like I said, minor down to major, using these two harmonies in the opposite direction. The post-guitar solo interlude begins with B flat Dorian and heads down to A Lydian, and we see another example of this up a fifth. F minor to E2. And although that isn't a major or minor E, that G sharp and A sharp pretty clearly indicate we're seeing F Dorian to E Lydian. Boy, you'd think the guy got paid every time he mixed E and F consecutively by this point, wouldn't you? But Alien Orifice is a completely chromatic tune. And again, if you'd like to learn more, I have a whole long video where I blabber about it, just like I am in this video. Another example comes from the Grand Wazoo. So a spoiler here for later, we see F major heading down a step to E minor. But for now we're concerned with this E minor 11 to E flat major 9. This all looks very squarely in D Dorian until that E flat. Well, I think this is another instance of borrowing. Look at the next change right after, G minor 11, and we know how closely related these two are. This time again, borrowing from Phrygian. An interesting thing Zappa did on some King Kong solo sections was insert another minor down to major progression. The main theme is an E-flat Dorian, and as we can hear on Hammersmith Odeon, for example, he uses this alternating progression of E-flat minor 7 down to D major 7 for a solo section, using E-flat Dorian to D Lydian. This presents enough of a modal switch while staying static enough to satisfy his improvisational needs. Earlier we looked at 20 Small Cigars and saw a minor up to major with E minor to F. Well, later on, we have two examples of minor down to major, and here's the first. We see G minor 7 to F sharp major 7. Of course, these share some common tones and harmonically, B flat or A sharp, and then F or E sharp. The G and D move down to F sharp and C sharp. Zappa cleverly utilizes the common tones in this melody, keeping that F or E sharp as the first note and hitting A over G minor and G sharp over F sharp major. Here's the second time we have a minor down to major. So we have B minor 7 to B flat major 7. The melody is pretty much chord tones here. D, which is the minor third of B, before a straight B flat major arpeggio over B flat major 7. A really pretty tune, and melodically sort of pleasantly simplistic to nicely counter the roaming chromatic harmony we have. And finally, in Drowning Witch, possibly my favorite section of music that Zappa ever wrote. I don't want to give away too much now so I can properly talk about it in the future, but after his B minor guitar solo, we see this unbelievably gorgeous melody over F sharp minor, which drops down a step to F major and sees Lydian. Needless to say, this is chromatic and just gorgeous. So how about major up to minor now? Between the two triads of a major and a minor up a step, they actually share a note. The root and fifth both move up a step and the third stay the same. So C to D flat minor, for example, both have E and the enharmonic of F flat, although same pitch class in this example. Maybe a better example would be E flat major 7 sharp 11 E minor 11, as we see in Alien Orifice. Just on the triads you can see again, the root and fifth both move up, E flat to E and B flat to B, while G, the major third of E flat, remains as it becomes the minor third of E minor. Zappa plays with another common tone between them, A, in the melody. Alien Orifice again is a completely non-functional piece, built on modal center switching. Another good example, and the only one on this video that comes from a synclavier track, is Night School. Let's listen. We start off over the C pedal, and you can see the triads over it, G, D, and C. Those are all part of C Lydian. Remember, having a major 2 over a major 1 is a very easy way to tell right away, since the major 2 contains the sharp 4 of the root. In this case, the F sharp in the D triad is the sharp 4 over the pedal, C. Then after this lick in the bass, you can see it moves up a step, now pedaling C sharp. There's two harmonies over it. First we have D sharp, E, A sharp, and then E, F sharp, B. Well, that's six notes, and if you put it together with the root, you get C sharp Dorian. You can see he takes this nice crunchy voicing of the second, minor third, and sixth, and moves it up diatonically, to the minor third, fourth, and seventh. Of course, it's worth noting that that voicing is an E sus2 on its own, and he just takes that up and moves it up a step to F sus2, as the bass moves down, back to C. You may have noticed the A naturals in the bass lick here. It technically rubs against that A sharp, but it just happens so fast, I'm not sure we should be concerned. So overall in Night School, we have C Lydian to C sharp Dorian as our major up to minor. But there's one really great example of this, a sensitive waltz off Zappa in New York that I think will benefit all of us by using the title of Leather. Leather is pretty much built entirely off Zappa's favorite chord progression here. Check it out. It begins with this sort of hocketed line between the five-piece horn section. Each melody note comes in an eighth from the last one, so you can see the rhythm is just 1 and 2 and 3 and. Although since that ends up with 6 beats being played in total, that means one instrument has to play 2 notes, while most of the others play 1. Trombone in bar 1, and both alto and trumpet in bar 2. The harmony spells out C minor 11 to D flat major 7 sharp 11, black napkins down a step. Then you can see this new rhythmic thing come in as the keys continue playing the previous pattern, but the harmony is still C minor to D flat major. And then something really interesting happens. From that D flat major, we see the root ascend up another step, this time to D minor, then E flat major. So really all this is a 2-bar sequence. He's taking the black napkins progression and just continuing it. C minor, D flat, D minor, E flat. But right there in the middle is where we get our major up to minor. And just like we talked about, he loves the stepwise root movement. And the piano solo really takes that to the extreme. The sequence that begins on A minor to B flat major 7 repeats up again as B minor to C major 7. Then instead of keeping it going in that pattern, he takes the C major 7 and turns it into C minor 7, and now begins the sequence there now. C minor to D flat major 7, D minor to E flat major 7, just like in the melody. Such a gorgeous tune and a great experiment on this chord progression. That brings us to our last category here, major down to minor. What better to start with than Peaches and Regalia? Thank you. Here we see A down to G sharp minor. Again, this major down to minor is just the black napkins progression reversed. And with every other type, there's plenty of examples that differ depending on the context. But here, just like in Black Napkins, well, at least in that melody, he uses a scale that works over both harmonies. In Black Napkins, it was C sharp pentatonic, and here it's G sharp pentatonic. So the same idea, really. You can see all those notes work for both changes. Now we should go back a little bit and give some more context, because it doesn't just come out of nowhere. The section before is the famous guitar solo. You could all probably sing this just looking at it, right? The changes are E to F sharp minor, the night owl-like stepwise root movement we've seen so much of. We're pretty firmly in the key of E here. The A major down to G sharp progression really fits in that key, now working as 4 down to 3. And that's not the only time he's used A down to G sharp minor. We also have Father Oblivion.
There's a light in Lovely Brown, they're the finest in the town. There's a light in Lovely Brown, they're the finest in the town. Good morning, Your Highness. Good morning, Your Highness.
Now you can see he's providing us with a little more melodic information this time than in Peaches. On its own, it almost seems like A Lydian if we were to assign that root there. But again, we have to look at the context.
Thomas Vocus gun that conspiracy to woe. Won't you eat my sleazy pancakes just for saintly Alfonso? There's a light in the white.
This section, which is sort of like a mambo, is based around this F sharp minor chromatically descending movement. Some people refer to this as the minor line cliche, because it's something we see so often. It's seen a lot in Latin music. Jazz. And pop. And that's not even the only time Zappa would use this.
Later that night.
On its own, as it's used here, it's a Dorian sound because of that major six. Basically like that 1-4 Dorian thing we talked about with that extra little voice leading. So really this A major down to G sharp minor is coming from this F sharp Dorian context, now working as 3-2. Interesting that we can have both of these examples of A to G sharp minor and both work diatonically in completely different contexts. And how about these changes but down a step, this time A flat major 7 to G minor 7, as heard here in Inca Roads. Well, this is George Duke's built-in solo section, and it's used chromatically, the same as we would see Black Napkins, but in reverse. Lydian down to Dorian now. He'll usually play A and D naturals over the G minor. And how about another major down to minor used as a solo section? This time F to E minor in Any Kind of Pain. But unlike Inca Roads, this one I would argue is diatonic. Zappa only uses F Lydian for his soloing, not switching to Dorian over the E minor. Now we're going to get into the specific thing Zappa uses a lot, which is a diatonic walkdown, and it's exactly as it sounds. A lot of times we'll see the major down a step to minor, but he just keeps it going. So really it just ends up going down the scale, using that stepwise root movement. Let's look at the Grand Wazoo again. We also have Sofa. Punky's Whips again. Absolutely Free. Mother People. And then Blessed Relief. And now we'll end with four last examples that are chromatic, each to a greater extent than the last. First, Strictly Genteel. This tune has some flat-out amazing things going on, and here's a really great section. What sticks out to me immediately is these F-sharps, G-sharps, and C-sharps over the D harmony here. So, Lydian. And as he slides down to C-sharp minor, what's the first thing we see but an F-sharp triad in the melody? We've talked a lot about the relationship and implication of that 4 chord over a minor 1, and how that means Dorian. Well, it's no different here. And another modal center switch. D Lydian to C-sharp Dorian, just as we saw in Black Napkins and Andy, but now reversed. So why stop there? He just slides it down again to C, and once again, he gives it away in the first melodic notes, F-sharp and D, implying a 2 chord, as he does here with the root and third of D major, over a major tonic is always going to give us Lydian. So all in all, D Lydian, down a step to C-sharp Dorian, then down another step to C Lydian in this example. So you can see how you can stack these sequences as much or as little as possible. How about dog breath variations? Well, it's right at the end of the tune. It's pretty easy to identify that descending chromatic line in the bass. F sharp minor, F major, E minor, and E flat major. As this line descends, he has this nice contrary motion with another line, going up as B, the 11th of the harmony, C, the 5th, D, the 7th, then matching the bottom line on E flat. So all in all, it's just voice leading here in this chromatic fashion. By the way, be on the lookout on my buddy Samuel R. Howard's channel. He's got a whole video on dog breath that'll be coming out. And our last two are very similar. Remember how in Leather he used the progression in ascending fashion? Well, these are descending. Let's start with Don't You Ever Wash That Thing. Here we're seeing essentially the same idea, right? Take the Black Napkins progression and use it in sequences. This time starting on a major, B flat major 7 sharp 11, and going down. The only thing is that it's not exactly major to minor each time. So after B flat we see A minor, then A flat major 7, and then G sus, not minor, down to F sharp minor 7 flat 5. After that he returns to the progression with F major 7 down to E minor, before going back up a third to G sus. The reason he does that is because the chord after this is C, so it's a 5-to-1 resolution. And here, the soloist, George Duke in this case, which, by the way, good lord, do we even talk enough about how insane of a musician he was? That solo was nuts. But George Duke treats each like Lydian or Dorian, except for the sus to minor 7 flat 5 chords. And for our last example, one that may surprise you a bit, let's look at Heavy Duty Judy. So this is a section that didn't make the Shut Up and Play Your Guitar album, but did make it to the Best Band You Never Heard in Your Life version. And again, we're taking this progression to the extreme. This time, all major to minor. A from the section before, to A flat, to G, to G flat, to F, to E, and then E flat. And there we go. So what can we take away from this besides just saying, yeah, Zappa used this progression all the time all over his music? Well, what I find so exciting is that he used it in a real variety of ways. Sometimes it's diatonic, or as a borrowed chord. Sometimes it's chromatic, or sometimes, as I showed, he just uses it in sequences or makes a whole tune out of it. So hopefully you've learned something new about Zappa's music here. And thanks for watching. It helps me out if you like, subscribe, share, all that good stuff. If you're insane enough to want to hear more of me discussing Zappa's music, here's a playlist of all those videos. And you can follow me on Instagram at Tyler Bartram. I'll see you next time.